I have many flavors memory. When we were very small, since we could walk, my father took to my sister and me to the market. So, I mean, we were 4 or 5 years old, and we went to with him every Saturday to the market. And I remind when we entered to the restaurant, and it was always boiling crab. You know, this smell so fresh, so deep of the ocean, of the crustaceans boiling, I will never remember. So I can't recognize a fresh boiling crab from kilometers. I grew up in San Sebastian. San Sebastian is a matriarchal society. My grandmother was a chef. My great-grandmother was a chef. My mother worked in the restaurant. She's not a chef, but she's very related to the gastronomy. In Arzak, 80% of the women, we are chefs, and with posts of responsibility. And I grew up only taking and being conscious that I needed to concentrate on forming myself, on working a lot, and not thinking if I'm a man or woman. My father, he was always very modern. And since the beginning, the first plate I did with him, I was 19 years old. Even if I was studying in Switzerland, in Lucerne, when I came back for holidays, I was in the hotel school there. And Elena, come on, show me something that you would. So, and we did together this first plate at that time. It was a salad of tuna, and he didn't like the sauce. He changed the sauce for a vinaigrette, and it was, people like it very much, no? And he showed me that he could rely on me, and he believed on my passion, no? And today is a day that he still, before coming here, Elena, take pictures. Take notes, you understand? He still talks about projects of future from here to 50 years. Oh, okay, it's fantastic, no? So long he's alive, he's my chef. We had spices at home, in the car, in the office, even in the car, no? And at the end, we didn't really know what we had. In the very first beginning, we tried to make groups, no? Salty, sweet, crispy. So, and we decide to group them. But some of the ingredients, imagine a sort of Hawaii. No, it was crispy, it was smoky, you understand? It was not so easy to, one ingredient could belong to 5 different families. If you mix 2 ingredients, perhaps you think it's another one. If you mix, for example, an ice cream of raspberry with tomato, at the end, you can think, you are not sure what is the flavor, no? But what I really like, more than mixing two combinations, is to try new ingredients. It's what, for me, gives new ideas. Today, I try an herb. It was from Ethiopia. It was like bitter, but very herbal, but agreeable. I don't remember the name. I have the name, no? For me, that was a new flavor. Imagine we make a taste of a plate, no? It can have a fish, it can have a garnish, no? Perhaps my family, we taste it, and perhaps we only like the garnish, and we don't like the fish, and perhaps we like the sauce. So what we do is we notice everything, we store everything for, perhaps for our next plate. For me, the future is a little bit taking the essence, like I'm talking about this apparently simplicity and having a very, very, very close relation to the producers. And to tell them, you know, I would like that you grow these seeds that perhaps I brought from Mexico. Could you make me the favor? So perhaps a pepper in Mexico is not the same. The soil doesn't react the same in San Sebastian than in Oaxaca, no? And I like that, no? And I think this is the future, but always into the frame of sustainability, you understand, and respecting the nature. And I think this is the future.